Hello, my dear children. I welcome you all to your English class. I hope you all are healthy and happy. So, children, for today's English lesson, we are going to continue with the third chapter from your Honeysuckle book. And the chapter is Tarot's Reward. You are aware that we have already finished two video lessons from this chapter, and this video is going to be the third part of the same. In our previous video lessons, we have finished the explanation and understanding of the text and also the question answers that is there in your book, the working with the text part. Now in this video lesson, we are going to move ahead and work with the language part. But before that, I would like to recall what we have learned about Tarot. Okay, so Tarot was a very dutiful and obedient son to his parents. He put in a lot of efforts to see his parents happy. Okay, he worked day and night to give them a comfortable life. Okay, but he was merely a woodcutter and a very poor one. So this meant that he could not afford everything that could give them comfort. So one day, his father desired to have sake because of the cold winds blowing and chilling his bones. So he wanted some warmth for his heart and for his soul. So he said to his son that he wished to have sake. And Tarot was so much disappointed, not because he did not want to give his father the thing he wanted, but because he could not afford it. He did not have enough money to buy sake. Okay, so again he put a lot of hard work. He started working for longer hours, but still he was very short of money. So one day while he was walking and chopping wood, he heard a rushing stream nearby. But he was surprised because never before he heard a running stream, or he never knew of any waterfall in that part where he was chopping the wood. Okay, so but he still continued working, and when he heard the noise, when he heard the sound of it, he was yet more thirsty. Okay, he could not suppress his thirst anymore, and he ran towards the sound. Now when he reached the place from where the sound of the rushing stream was coming, he saw that the waterfall was just behind the rock. So now he went there and he drank the water, but actually it was not water but sake. He tasted it again and again, but it still was sake. So he filled the drink, means he filled the expensive Japanese drink into his pitcher, and he took it home. When his father got a sip of the magical drink, he was very delighted, he was very happy, and he also did a quick dance, you remember, just a happy dance. So this made Tarot really happy. So in the same evening, a neighbor, a lady, came to their house, and Tarot's father was very generous because they had sake at home. He could not not offered the lady the same thing, so he offered sake to the neighbor. And this neighbor was surprised that how this poor family could afford sake. Okay, and Tarot's father and Tarot told her all the story about the magic waterfall. So this lady could not control it. She quickly had her sip, she finished her drink, and then she went to the village, and every household now knew about the magic waterfall. They all came to Tarot's house and they inquired about the magic waterfall, and then they speeded to their home. They sped to their home, means they ran back quickly. Now, because Taro knew that there was this sake in the waterfall, he wanted to go there early in the morning, very early than the previous day, because he had that task to do. He had to collect the sake. But when he reached there, to his surprise, he found that the villagers were already there. Okay, they were present there with buckets and all the large containers they could have. So one of the villagers went there, knelt like Taro did, and he just tasted sake. He brought this water to his lips. Okay, but it was a shock to him that it was water only and not sake like Taro told them, right? So they tasted again and again, one and two and three villagers, everyone tried, but it was plain cold water. Okay, this thing which was happening there near the waterfall was watched by Taro from behind. The villagers were very angry. Okay, they were very angry that they have been fooled by Taro. Taro and his father and his family had lied to them. So they wanted to drown Taro in the same waterfall, in the water of the same fall. Okay, so all this thing was heard by Taro, and he slipped behind the rock. Okay, he did not want to come out because obviously they will be killing him. So he hid there. Now all the villagers, when they were angry, when they're abusing, when they were cursing Taro, okay, they were tired of it, and then they went to back to their homes. Now Taro came out of his hiding place and again thought, was I dreaming? Was it not sake? So he went there again to the waterfall, and again he tasted the water. So yes, it was sake still only for him. Okay, so this thing, again he filled up his pitcher and he went back home. The emperor of Japan heard his story, means heard it from somewhere else, and about him and the magic waterfall, and he called him to his court. Okay, he sent for him, and Taro was rewarded with 20 gold coins, right? And then one more thing, that the king named the famous fountain of the city in Taro's name. Okay, so this was a beautiful story, and we learned that being obedient to parents and loving them from your heart can reap a very rich reward. Okay, so not in the form of only the magic waterfall. Even if magic exists, magic can happen. Okay, and also you are always you feel always happy, okay, within you. When your family is happy, when your parents are happy with you, you feel really blessed. So this was a beautiful story with a more beautiful moral. Okay, and here we had finished the story. So today we will be working with the language part. So this working with language is on page number 35. We will be writing, we will be going through the instruction, what we have to do. So the first part is strike off the words in the box below that are not suitable. Taro wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. This shows that he was everything that a good son could be, right? So what was he? If you can see this box, okay, you have this box right here. You have certain words there. What are these words? Thoughtful, hardworking, loving, honest, considerate, trustworthy, efficient, kind. Now what do I want you to do is first find the meanings of these words, okay, and then strike it out. Now, was Taro a thoughtful son? Yes, he was, because he considered the need of his parents a lot, right? It was his utmost priority. Now, he was hardworking, yes, because although he was poor, he wanted to make more money, and for that you have to work hard. You can't get money by magic, okay? Loving, yes, he was a loving son. Now, honest, in this story there's no context as honest. Considerate, yes. considerate he was, right? Because he was considerate of the needs of his parents. Trustworthy? No. Because this story has nothing to do with trust, right? And kind? Yes, he could be kind, right? You have to be kind to your loved ones. So this can be the answer. Okay, so this part remains your homework because I want you to write the meanings of it. Okay, now children, what I want you to do is understand that these words which are in the bracket are actually what? Which parts of speech do you feel are these words? If you see thoughtful, loving, honest, you might have heard about a parts of speech which is adjective. Have you heard it? I hope so. So now, what are adjectives? Adjectives are words that modify a noun or change or add the meaning to a noun or pronoun. Okay, so with adjectives, this is in your grammar syllabus as well. That's why we will be doing that. But before you move to the grammar lesson, we will be considering a slight detail on it because here we have adjectives. Okay, so first one is thoughtful. See, like thoughtful son. So let me write it down for you that what is an adjective. Okay, an adjective is a word that describes or modify a noun or a pronoun. Okay, for examples are a good boy, boy, a pretty woman, woman, a 5 rupee note, and etc. etc. Now here you can see boy is a noun, this one is a noun, okay, and good is describing the boy. So how is the boy? The boy is good. So that's the reason that this good becomes the adjective, okay, because it is describing the noun boy. And here also you can see that woman is a noun and pretty is the adjective describing this word. 5 rupee note. So how many? So you have got to ask yourself some important questions, okay? And we will be doing this when we do the grammar lesson for adjective and comparison of adjectives. Hopefully in our next lesson we will be touching that part of grammar. So here is just to give a slight idea of adjectives so you can understand. Now for after this we will be striking off the A part now. Okay, Taro wanted to give his old parents everything they needed. This shows that he was first because he wanted to give them. Now he was trustworthy, honest, and efficient. Okay, trustworthy, honest, efficient. Now we are going to strike off the word that do not show tarot's true character. Okay, what are these words? Honest won't be, okay, trustworthy and efficient. You need to strike these three words because it doesn't suit or it doesn't fit tarot's character. So let's write it down. You have to strike this off, means you have to strike it. You know how you striking is done, right? You write a word like it's honest here and you then strike it off. Okay, so this is striking. You can do it, I think. And so okay, I don't need to show this now. Okay, so the words you're cancelling or striking off are honest, trustworthy, trustworthy and efficient. Rest of the words describe tarot really well. Tarot is a noun. Tarot is the name of a person. So the words describing him are the rest of the words apart from this. So this is an adjective. These words are adjective because it's describing tarot. It's describing a noun. Okay. So number B now. Now we will move to B. This made tarot sadder than ever. This refers to a strong wind that began to blow, Taro's father's old age, Taro's inability to buy expensive sake for his father. Okay, so this word because this made Taro, what this is describing a noun. It is talking about a noun. So what is that? Taro's inability is this. So your correct answer will be number 3. Now let's write it down. Number B, it's all in page number 20, 35. Okay, number B, number 1's answer is, I'm writing just the answer but you have to write the question as well. Number 3, Taro's inability to buy sake for his father. Okay. Now number 2 is the, let's write it down here. This said the emperor was to encourage all children to honor and obey their parents. Okay, this refers to the most beautiful fountain in the city, rewarding Taro with gold and giving the fountain his name. And 3, sending for Taro to hear the story. You know how what was the reward, right? The reward was gold coins and giving the fountain his name. So we will be writing that down as well. Number 2, the correct answer is number 2. For 2, the correct answer is 2. Rewarding Taro with gold with gold and giving the fountain his name and giving the fountain his name. His name. Okay. Now, moving to the C part. Arrange the words below in pairs that rhyme. You know what is rhyming, right? Rhyme have the same sound almost. So, young, lung. Can you hear the last sounding? The sound of the last syllable. So, young, lung. Money, sunny. Now let's see if we could find as many words as possible. Before that, I want you to quickly take a screenshot if I rub the board for this part. Now, young, you have lung, it's already given. So we will be writing that first. Number C. We are on part C now. Young is lung. Young is rhyming with lung. And money is rhyming with sunny. It's rhyming with sunny. Now wax is rhyming with axe. Wax and axe. Okay. Sad is rhyming with bad. Sad, bad. Okay. Now, way is rhyming with day. Way is rhyming with day. Sound is rhyming with round. Sound round. Okay. First, last. First and last. They're rhyming. Chop. Stop, chop, stop. Good, wood. Good is rhyming with wood. Yes. Any more words? I guess we are done with it. And if I have missed any, you can complete it on your own, right? It can be a task to do, right? You can finish it on your own. Now, okay, now we will move to the D part. It's fill in the blanks with words from the box. This one is on page number 36. Now moving to page 36. Take a screenshot quickly. Yeah? Okay. So, now we are moving to D part. It's on page number 36. So, I'll be erasing this one as well. Now, page 36 and the D part. D. Okay, so what we are asked to do here, we have been asked to fill in the blanks with words from this box. Okay, now first word is lonely, second little, then hard, young, thoughtful, delicious, beautiful, all are adjectives. So now you got, I hope now you have an idea why I want you to know about adjectives. Just when we began this part working with the language, the first thing I told you was about adjective. So yes, now let's do it. A dash woodcutter lived on a dash hillside. So a young woodcutter lived on the dash hillside. So the first blank will be young, then the blank will have lonely, the next blank, let's read, he was a dash son who worked dash but earned dash money. So he was a thoughtful son. So he was a thoughtful son who worked dash, who worked hard, but earned dash money, little money. But earned little money. Yes. Next, one day, why I'm writing money? Because it's in your book already. So we don't need to write that. One day he saw a dash waterfall hidden behind a rock. Okay, a beautiful waterfall. A beautiful waterfall, okay. And the last blank now. He tasted the water and found it delicious. So this, he found it very tasty, delicious. Tasty is another adjective for delicious. Now these are the blanks that we need to fill in D's one. Now we will move to the second question of D. Find these sentences in the story and fill in the blanks. This made Taro dash than ever. You should, for this answer, you have to go to stanza 3 and you will find your answer. This made Taro sadder than ever. So the first answer is sadder. Okay, number 2. This one was number 1. And now we are moving to number 2. So the first answer of 2 is, this made Taro sadder than ever. Sadder. Okay. He decided to work dash than before. Okay, this is on page number, stanza number 3 again. So, he decided to work harder than before. So, the second answer will be harder. The third one now. Next morning, Taro jumped out of bed dash than usual. Okay, number 3's answer you will find in stanza 4. You can see there, next morning Taro jumped out of bed earlier than usual. Okay, so the next answer will be, third answer will be earlier than usual. Earlier than usual. Okay, number 4 now. He began to chop even dash. Now that's also on stanza 4. You can see the third line. He chopped and cut, chopped and cut. Okay, sorry. You will find that, yes. in 4 only, and it's in the second paragraph. And with that, he began to chop even faster. Okay, let's do that. Faster. And number 5 now. This is the last number of 2. Next morning, Taro started for work even dash than the morning before. So it's on stanza 10. We will be doing this. Let's search it first. Okay. Next morning, Taro started for work even earlier than the morning before. So again, we have to use this word earlier. Okay, again, the last one is also earlier. So this is all for our working with language. Talking about your speaking and writing part, we won't be able to do much here in the video. So we have to finish this in our online class, because that way it will be more productive and interactive. You have to write most of the things on your own, so this won't help. Thank you for joining the video lesson today. I hope you enjoyed it, and I hope you complete this work as well. So thank you for watching the video. Hope you join soon again in the next video. Bye bye.